Okay, we're back.
Before we should mention that you have a very interesting show coming on Sunday. All the comedians that made their first start on the Tonight Show.
I'm doing a special on NBC this Sunday night from 10 to 11 called The Tonight Show Comedians. And that's exactly what it is. It's a show featuring a lot of the performers who either made their very first appearance on The Tonight Show or whose career is kind of tied to The Tonight Show from their appearances. We've got Rodney Dangerfield, clips of Rodney and George Carlin. And then working with me live are going to be Steve Martin, Bill Cosby, Joan Rivers. That's this Sunday night at 10 o'clock, I guess, around the country. I think you'll find it a lot of fun. Okay, here is my first guest, our new ambassador to the UN. Known for his warmth, Don's going to be appearing for a week at Harrah's in Reno, November the 29th, and Resorts International, December the 7th, 8th, and 9th. Will you welcome Mr. Warmth, Don Rickles.
Okay, that's about it. Hi, gobble gobble and all that, you know. I was home stuffing a pilgrim. But I look forward to Thanksgiving.
Really?
Yeah, it's a great Jewish holiday. And, pilgrims were all Jews. They came out of Maine. Little payas and little turkeys under their arm.
Pardon me? I didn't know that.
You don't know a lot of things.
That's true.
How do you feel, Ed?
Fine, Don, thank
good.
You.
The other night was so great. When we were out with Victoria, Barbara, and I. His name came up, what, once?
Twice, yeah.
One time was about him quitting, and you said, who cares? And the other time was about you sitting there.
Ed has eyes on the old chair, does he?
Well, you know, he says he's going to quit. He makes that speech all the time, his contract, that, you know, when you go, he goes, you know.
That's right.
Don't count on it. God forbid 100 times you get hit by a bus, he won't pick it up to let you lay there.
He's got too many things going anyway.
Yeah, he's a big star, and I'm happy for him. Star Search, Hit the Dong, Win a Cookie, How's Your Mother, Long Live Ireland, A Parade, and Two Monkeys in Heat on a Rock, whatever it is. But he's got it all covered. Hi, guys in the band, haven't seen you in a while. Good. The shipment will be in Friday.
How are you feeling?
Great. The end of August, we went on a trip, and we did the, my wife and I, for the first time. You going to say something?
No.
Oh, you always do? You got a rod, maybe we can reel him in. I mean, I was toy. That's a sign of age, when you start to go, I forgot I wanted to say something. But, we went on a trip. I don't lie. You're old. We went on a trip, John, and we visited. I told the wife and I, 20 years of marriage in March, and it's our first time we went on a trip alone. We said we're definitely going to go alone. And
because you've never traveled with Barbara anyplace, just by the two of you?
You've met Barbara.
Yes.
Now, would you like to be in a bedroom with her just laying there going, okay, it's your turn. No, she's a lovely wife. She really is. I say this publicly. I married a Valium. On the wedding night, I had to do, come on. Gee, that wasn't worth the joke. I hurt myself.
But where did you go on this trip?
That was good.
Thank you.
Say, where did you go on the trip? Well, we went to where you've been, to the south of France. Ed, have you ever been to the south?
Yes,
you've been all over. That's a dumb question to ask you. I mean, you're like a barge. They put a flag on your can, you'll go any place. Come on, I laugh at this show. But I'll tell you this. We went to the south of France.
I have to do a commercial.
Oh, fine. Anything to keep you going. But your payments do a lot of them. Anyway.
You got that right. We'll be right back after
this. So old.
Yeah, old. Oh.
our back.
Look, we just had you embarking on this trip to the south of France.
Yes, first time. So we went to La Réserve, and we took a ship called the Sea Goddess, which, by the way, is great sailing. It's a new kind of a... It's like, it's like a yacht, you know, with 60 cabins and 100 passengers, all well-to-do people. You'd be a little uncomfortable because they would recognize you, and you know how you are with your body and the whole thing with the shorts on and so forth. He's very, you know, he's very barbell happy. He's the type of guy that goes, you see it dancing? Anyway, but this ship we went on, and we got to La Réserve, and we checked in very nice, and... the phone rings, and it's a man that I know you look up to. Well, certainly Ed and I do. You're a little shaky about it. Frank Sinatra, who is one of the great stars of our time. Mm-hmm. And we say this because he has Ed's sister and my aunt in custody. No, that's a joke. If Frank's listening, buonasera, buonasera, buonasera. But we had a marvelous time. And he was at the Hotel de Paris, which you know well, and he had a beautiful suite. He had the entire building. And every day we went over and spent time with him. And the one thing I remember, you know, the French, the paparazzi, like a few, do they recognize you when you go over there?
Some of them.
Who?
Jacques Bidou.
Jacques Bidou?
Jacques Bidou.
Look that up. I want you to check that out. Jacques Bidou, I happen to know, was in La Cage aux Folles and is still not sure what he is. Now, I want Jacques Bidou, my burgers, Jacques Bidou. They don't know you over there. Why don't you be a man about it? You and Newhart, you lie. I hate that. Nobody knows you. They only know Frank. And I'm going to see to it that you get hurt. Now, not you, Ed, because this is going to be your desk. Now... And then Sinatra was marvelous. Needless to say, we went over there and people...
Do you speak French?
Pardon me?
Was that a tough one?
Do you speak French?
Of course. Any Jew from Brooklyn speaks French. I get up in the morning, I say to my wife, je ne m'entends pas de moi. She said, no donuts. Now, of course I don't speak French. I got enough trouble in the neighborhood trying to let them know who I am. Right. Don't steam me. You're getting on my nerves.
Right.
You came from... When I met you, you were just out of Nebraska saying, get me a monkey, anybody, help me. Well, sure. Women were out of the question. Now... Look at your track record with girls. Forget about it. I mean, I don't want to throw that up. The public doesn't have to know. What? You let them know. I mean, Ed, you've been married once. I've been married just once. Yeah. No, you've been married twice. Anyway, Well,
I get it. Sure.
But we go back a lot of years, so I can take those
pictures. Of course you can.
But getting back to Frank, so I was with Sinatra 5 days and five nights. Frank was great. Every night, little booze. Well, you used to drink. You don't drink anymore.
Not much.
Yeah, and look what it's done to you. You were laughs when you drank in New York when you saw me at the Copa. Now you sit out at the beach and say, is the lawyer on the phone? Now, you see, you gotta be like Ed. He drinks, but nobody knows about it. Anyway, you're going to get a call from Victoria saying, yes. Why is he saying that? No, we all drink with moderation. Yes. But that's at the point. Frank still drinks pretty good. You know, little grappa. You know what grappa is?
Sure.
What is it?
It's a little Italian wine.
What?
Big wine.
Hey, it's not an open forum.
Little grappa.
Let the man that gets $60 million a week figure out the answers.
Well, that was in a year. It used to be $40.
No, Grappa.
Well, did anything exciting happen on the vacation?
Yes, on the...
Never mind the knee dropping. Let's get on with the...
Well, hey, being with Sinatra to me is exciting. It's exciting for you, isn't it, Ed?
Sure.
Being with you would be like a slow-up. Being with you would be fun, but in a different way, John. You're low-key. You don't like to, you know...
That's right.
Frank likes to sit around by the cabana with a lot of Italian guys and the priest. And, you know, and look around, and if somebody is swimming towards the cabana, he goes, shoot him. So we have a different relationship, you know. You like to sit there and explain to some 19-year-old that the graying is from an illness.
A problem you will never have. You gotta get one for Nebraska.
Yeah. Nebraska leading the Jew 1-0 going into the last game. But really, and you know, and then we went to Saint-Tropez on the Sea Goddess with Harvey Silbert. I don't know if you know Harvey.
Yes,
he's a wonderful guy. And Jerry Vale was singing on the ship, and it almost sunk. Bob Newhart didn't want to go along. You know, it was too much money.
I thought you went along with Barbara.
Yeah, I did. But Jerry Vale was on the ship singing.
Oh, I see. And then Newhart was Newhart was there too.
No, Newhart was on the dock going, "I can't afford it." He's a multimillionaire. You know, he's starting to catch up to you. Anyway, by the way, that's where I'm going to spend Thanksgiving with Bob Newhart and his family.
Oh,
party nice. Of about 40. And it's going to be catered. Mm. And it's going to be nice. You were on the list, but we voted and... We figured you prefer chicken. And there's not a bit of Jewish blood in you. I don't know why you'd want chicken, but anyway. But it was marvelous. You know, we went to the Hotel de Camp.
That's beautiful.
It is a beautiful hotel. And it's about 7 miles to the tennis courts, you know. And it was very reserved, you know. A lot of Ed Thompsons with the, you know, big boil on the neck. "I believe, Mary, it's your serve." You know. And there was one Jew that came down and said, did anybody see a ball? Anyway, and two Italian guys in the cabanas going... And one black guy going, "I'm playing tennis." Anyway.
They were all there.
My goodness. At the hotel.
What a lucky break for you.
At our place, there was none of that.
That's right.
But I must tell you, Sinatra, we talked about the night when I was with him with these 5 days. We talked about the night when he hosted the show and the night when he was a guest, if you remember that. And he had a lot of fun. Because Frank is... as you know, and I know, and certainly Ed knows too, that he's the kind of guy that, to be with him, you know, it's the last of a great kind of world, you know, and to be with him, you see the other side of him, you know. Yeah. When he got my wife against the wall, I kept, you know, I said, "Go, Frank, go, go."
It's him.
Punch the hell out of it. He was great. don't ever do this. Never do this when you're talking about Sinatra. It could bend on you. Okay. We'll be right back.
They're laughing over here.
He's grinning at me because of the way I'm looking
he's being,
at you.
You're being so well behaved with me tonight, it threw me.
Well, I think I'm a... Well, when I'm in your company, I'm at a clinic. No, you're so beautiful, and I love my wife, but she is ill.
You're looking for a mercy date, is this what you're saying?
Now, Angie's gorgeous, and she has a great sex and charm, which you know and I know. Ed knows because his leg keeps going.
Well,
she's
anyway.
A darling lady. She really is. And a grown daughter, which is lovely, too.
Yeah. And a pretty gal, too.
Yeah.
Did you know yourself that you're a...
I didn't expect you to ask me what I'm doing nights and if I'm alone and everything. And
I just thought it would be intriguing to find out.
I think it's kind of nosy. I'm sure she's very active in her social life. I don't mean a bed and things like that.
You don't mean an acrobat or anything?
No, nothing on a high wire with a canary, nothing like that, you know. And I know you very, very, you date constantly. Do you? Anyway, the heck with it. Let's get it.
Always good to see you, though.
Yeah, you too.
Yeah. We're going to do a little, what is that, Fred? What does that mean?
Well, it's whatever you want to do, sir.
Used to talk to Bunzo the same way.
With the same results.
With the same results. Cute. Bunzo's dead, you know.
Except it's my story.
Yes.
Okay, boys, hold it up, huh?
Did you know Mr. De Cordova directed Bedtime for Bunzo?
Yes, you know, I met Freddie. The first time I ever met Freddie, he directed me on a Jack Benny show. At least I think that was the first time.
First time we talk about.
Uh-huh.
That's the first time I met right. Freddie. Uh-huh. Well, Jack Benny.
I met Freddie. No.
We're going to take a break and we're going to come right back and try to get some kind of sense out of this. Well, folks, 2:00 on the wall. Oh, tell me. You said you're going to Canada. You're reading a script. You may go to Canada and make a picture?
Montreal.
Yeah.
For NBC, but I haven't read it. It just came this afternoon.
It's a beautiful city up there.
It is. I did another movie there. It's wonderful.
Yeah. I hope you'll come back soon.
I hope back, so.
Maybe later tonight?
Thank you.
You never know whether I'm kidding or serious.
Yeah.
Right? You know that.
That's strange.
Yes. But thank you for coming. It's always nice to see you and renew old friendships. And, Don, you're headed for Oblivion.
To Angie's house.
Yes, Angie's house. No, Don is going to, Seed is where he's going.
Yeah.
No. He's going to Harrah's in Reno, November the 29th, and then the Resorts International in Atlantic City, isn't it?
Yes, and then I'm coming back here to give you a shock treatment.
Thank you very much. Hey, it's nice to have you here.
Nice to be back, John.
I know
and
it
a
is.
Happy Thanksgiving to you and your big party that you're going to have.
Thank you.